for the elements, still nice to watch. Yeah, now we have the second group, and we'll see Ilinich Zhiganchin and Sinitsina Katsalapov. So there was really quite a big score from Babrova Solovyov. So I don't think anyone will top that. But it is very exciting to see who will make the top three.
Definitely here. Elena Ilinich and Ruslan Zhiganchin will try. And of course, Katsalapov and Sinitsina team.
Yeah, and they too were in the USA with Marina Zueva, and then he had, right after Worlds, he had shoulder surgery, and it took him a long time to recover. And they also returned to Russia, and he said it was mainly because of his ongoing therapy, and it's just too expensive, the USA, because it costs a lot of money, also living there, so they went back to Russia, and they here in Russia working with Oleg Volkov, but Marina Zueva was at Cup of China with them, and he said that they are consulting with her on the phone and sending videos, so she is helping them. Last year she was with them at Russian Nationals, remember?
Yes. She came, she was here in Yekaterinburg, but Marina is now very busy. She's started coaching singles also, so she's coaching full-time Patrick Chan, and we saw her also
working with Nathan Chan.
So she's in between two chances.
Yeah.
Maybe she can't get a chance.
I was joking, it's Patrick and his American cousin. Yeah, so Marina not here this time, but Oleg Volkov. And yeah, and Ilinich Zhiganchin, as you said, were with Igor for a couple of months, Igor Spielband, and he did their programs. And then they also returned. And again with the Kustarova-Alexeeva group. There is Yelena Kustarova, Svetlana Alexeeva, and Olga Ryabinina from left to right at the boards, watching close every move. There's Maria Stavitskaya and Andrei Bagin. Maria, former single skater from Alexei Mishin's school. Switch to ice dance. Yeah, we had a few also that Ilya Zimin, the guy from St. Petersburg, the ice dancer, he was a pair skater even.
Yes.
And then went to ice dance. And there's Vasilisa Davankova.
Also
a former pair skater.
Pair skater, now ice dancer, and wife of Nikolai Morozov.
I haven't seen Nikolai yet. Is he here?
Yeah. We were just talking to each other. He's right there. If you can see, it's by the board.
And the boards, yeah.
Same black coat, intense look, and we will see how he's going to perform on the board side, because he usually throws a really good performances. Most of the people sometimes they watch not the skaters, they watch
Nikolai.
Well,
there he is, just talking of him.
He's getting ready for a performance. This is actually debut for his wife, competing at Russian Nationals.
In ice dance, she was with Enbert in pairs and Steputat in pairs. And they will skate last today, so we will start with Sinitsina and Katsalapov now. So the Grand Prix, they finish off the podium.
Nikita has Olympic gold medal, team competition Sochi, also bronze medal with Elena Ilinich, who will skate a little bit later.
She looks a bit like Tatiana Navka when she has her hair like that.
Yeah, with this hair. They are a couple on ice and off ice. Nice deep edges.
Yeah, for the blues part. Twizzles.
Almost.
Yeah.
Good speed.
Also very nice. So maybe just the little his last twizzle. Alec Epstein
came from
USA.
from Detroit.
Also a very well respected ice dance coach who has moved to the USA.
Originally from Yekaterinburg, works with Marina Zueva. and here he works with Oleg Volkov.
Yeah, Oleg Volkov knows Nikita for a long time. He's worked with him and Nikita and Yelena were skating in Alexander Zhulin's group.
Now they are no longer working together.
No, he's separated.
Something happened. Oleg Volkov, former ice dancer, used to skate with Elena Koltsova from Odessa. She lives in Fort Lee, USA, near New York. And Oleg used to skate in Holiday on Ice, early 90s. And then he came back to Russia and started coaching.
He was also coaching in France.
He was coaching in France, correct.
Yeah, for a couple of years. It was like Roxane Petitin and Mathieu Jost.
Wow, you impressed me again.
But then he came back here to Russia and
started working with Alexander Zhulin.
Yeah, for many years.
For many years.
Oh, he was in, but first he was in Odintsova also.
Odintsova.
Yeah,
he started in Odintsova.
Alexei
Gorshkov.
Gorshkov. Then when he was with Zhulin, and now I think he is in Moscow in the Belyaevo ice rink, where Ksenia Rumyantseva is also working. I think that's where he is based now. So, Nikita.
73-78 on the third place.
So behind Stepanova Bukin, 3 points almost.
Well, let's see who's gonna make the team three for Europeans. After a short dance, obviously the leaders are going to be Bobrova Solovyov and Stepanova Bukin.
Yevtokimova and Bazin. It's a team from
Tolyatti, from Samara region.
Competed at Junior Worlds in 2015.
Coached by Oleg Sudakov.
Yeah, and it's also good to see that in a different region is represented. Tolyatti, Samara. They even competed, Yevtokimova Bazin, at the Rostelecom Cup of Russia Grand Prix. There was a few dancers coming from that school, and one of the most famous ones is Maxim Shabalin.
Maxim Shabalin with Oksana Domnina.
But that was before he skated with Oksana, when he was he skated with also.
You're gonna impress me again.
Yeah, I think Khalyavina.
Elena Khalyavina.
Yeah, that was
married
his part.
To Andrei Dostatny. Lives in Colorado. Used to live in Sun Valley, Idaho. Baby boy, actually not baby anymore, but beautiful boy. They have together with Andrei Dostatny. Andrei Dostatny is a technical controller.
Technical specialist.
He worked in the big major competitions already. Olympics, Worlds.
Yeah, he was one of the first generation of technical specialists.
Runs computer business.
It's from Poland originally.
Yeah, from Gdansk. City of Gdansk, that's the northern of Poland.
Look at this lift. This is a very cool lift.
It is. It's a really, really interesting position, and she holds. She gotta have a good stomach right there.
Yeah.
That's a great workout too. So maybe for the fitness program, they can use it. People who are watching.
And thank you also Robin Kanter and Fran Summers for watching our commentary, watching Russian Nationals and enjoying competition and sending us a message on Twitter. Wild train rolling, so wild and full of steam. Once you get us going, it's like nothing you have seen. With some fire in your twizzles, you'll move a little faster, and the devil in your eye makes you whip a little harder. Yeah, so Alex Sudakov. This is team at the international level. Don't know if they have, well, probably he has some juniors too, right?
Yes.
Oleg, he always has some skaters.
He runs the ice dancing in Toliati. Fifth
yeah.
place. Sofia Evdokimova, Yegor Bazin.
So now it's one more exciting team, Ilinich and Riganshin. Last year they were in their first season, they won Russian Nationals. And then the second season last year, they did not make the team for Europeans and Worlds. They finished fourth at Nationals. Now fighting to come back.
She's a diva. And that's their chance to make Europeans. Also, she has Olympic gold medal team competition, Sochi 2014.
same music for the swing as Poprova Solovyov.
Yeah.
Sing, sing, sing. Well, they gave really 100%.
Yeah, the coaches are happy, so.
They were really energetic and fighting for their spot.
So close with their rival team.
Yeah, the technical scores. We see.
Already 37.7, which is almost the same as Sinitsyna Katsalapov. They were like 38, I believe. So we will see overall what's gonna do.
It still might change when they adjust the level or so. It's not the final score.
Yeah, it's not the final, but they are very close.
Yeah. So, yeah, they had a very good short dance also at the Trophy Bompa. sorry, it's not Trophy Bompa anymore. They had a very good. yeah, Sorten at the Trophée de France Grand Prix in France, were second. Even
wow.
So, yeah,
nice.
Very intense.
Nice shot.
Even so, she was injured before that, and then they couldn't hold it in the free, and they slipped first place, but then and then they skated at the Tallinn Trophy Challenger Series event, and they got a personal best in the short dance with 76.04. Twizzles, that was what cost them last year. I think they fell on the twizzle in the short dance. Something happened last year. Yeah, it's tough. You have so many teams that are close to each other. But only three can go to Europeans. Elena Kusterova also pleased. So, exciting moment. It's almost the same.
Yeah.
That's
interesting, actually.
Very close. Very close to Sinitsyna and
Katsalapov.
They have 73.78 for Sinitsyna and Katsalapov. So it's half a point between them,
yeah.
Heading into the free dance.
They look disappointed.
Yeah.
Because for them it's so important. I mean, that their main competition is their former partners.
Mm. Yeah, they expected maybe more. Yeah. Maria Stavitskaya.
She was a good single skater. Then she got taller and taller, and here we are. We see her in ice dancing.
Your lips may be sweet, such that I can't.
He did one extra.
Yeah. So that's her new partner, actually. Last season she competed with Anton Chibnev. We'll see now with Vasilisa.
Maria Savitskaya, Andrei Bagin, Moskva.
He used to skate with Eva Khachaturian.
Yeah, what happened to her?
She's going to skate now for Georgia.
Yeah, true. There was a couple of skaters that were released for Georgia. Also,
yeah.
Moritz Kutelashvili also. But haven't seen him yet. Well, he has to wait.
He qualified. Probably. He will be at the Europeans.
Mm-hmm. And also Eteri's daughter, Diana,
yes,
is also going to skate for Georgia. And Georgia is getting a few more skaters.
Georgia is working hard. Maka. That's the name of their federation's president. Very nice person, trying really hard. And this year, she got a few skaters already going to be representing Georgia at European and World Championships.
Yeah, it's
right here.
The next one. Yeah, that was a twizzle.
Extra
twizzle. Miscalculated, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
There's also skating with Alexander Julin, and Bagin was with his former partner also in Julin's school. What you say? Oh, woman, don't treat me so mean. You're the meanest old woman that I ever seen. I guess if you say so, I'd have to back my things and go. That's right, keep the road, Jack. I don't come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Keep the road, Jack.
Yeah,
I remember Maria as a single skater at the Rostelecom Cup. doing triple-triple combinations.
Yeah, she was quite consistent.
Yeah.
Came a nice, good-looking lady.
Their debut at Nationals as an ice dancer. So judges still sinking. So now, the last couple, Vasilisa Davankova and Anton Tyepnev, Maria's former partner, and as we already said, the former pair skater, Vasilisa debuts as an ice dancer at Nationals.
Yeah, Nikolai has already started making the moves.
Yeah, of course, right to the right. It's even more nerve-wracking for him when his wife is skating.
We all know how interesting he can be by the board. His performance is always a piece of art. And after Tatiana Tarasova, he holds the second place in the world, in my book. Very soon I will release a video of coaches by the board. I have a lot of good footage.
The third time we are hearing this blues.
Yeah.
Oh no, he fell just on nothing.
Well, definitely he's nervous. First time competing. A lot of pressure.
That was the only fall in the ice dance competition.
Hold it.
Well, at least he didn't fall on an element, but still lose 1 point. Yeah, but I'm glad that Vasilisa is back, because I always enjoyed her. I liked her as a pair skater, but then, yeah, she grew a lot. But for a nice dancer, she has a good height. And she was with Deputat in 2012, a Volt Junior bronze medalist in pairs.
She looks happy.
Yeah.
They're having fun.
That's good, she's enjoying it.
The husband. Nikolai is a very interesting character. Many of us who know him, his legacy is quite amazing. He started with Tarasova and Alexei Yagudin back in 2000. And used to skate with Tatiana Navka.
Yeah. Representing Belarus.
Wearing high heels on his skates.
So in 2015, for the 2015 championship, it was in fall 2014, she was at Nationals for the last time as a pair skater with Alexander N. Oops, yeah, that was... At least he didn't take her down with him. Nikolai, that came unexpected to him too. Yeah, so 2 years ago with Alexander Enbert, she finished sixth in pairs. So then, back as ice dancer.
It's good that we can see, because technology is getting so much better, that the shots in the camera, close shots, are so interesting to see the emotions. And the points are 53.0, the score is 53.0, gives them 8th place. Well, that's their debut, it's okay.
Yeah, so that was the first day of Russian Nationals. We see the ice dance, strong lead for Yekaterina Poprova and Dmitry Solovyov.
Follow Alexandra Stepanova, Ivan Bukin going second place, strong second place, and then we have the third place is going to be tie, almost tie between two rival partners, and we will see what's going to happen in the finals. And now we're going to go for a rest, because yeah, it's quite late.
It's not that late.
For me it's late, I woke up at 5 o'clock.
So thank you for watching Russian Nationals with us today. We saw the men's short, the pair short, and the short dance.
And thank you to Tatiana Flade.
And Ari Zakarian. And tomorrow, we're happy to see you again. We will start tomorrow with the ladies' short program at 2 p.m. local time, followed by the men's free skating at 4:45 local time p.m., and the free dance tomorrow will be decided 8 p.m. So enjoy the last images for today. It's a short dance, and welcome to join us tomorrow again. Thank you for watching.
Thank you for watching. Goodbye for now.